to say he's a very good friend of a friend of mine. Oh, and the throat's as dry as a desert thistle in May. In the Golden Garter, gonna wet my whistle today. Last of the bars, a three-legged crow. Set 'em up, Joe, set 'em up, Joe, set 'em up, Joe. Set 'em up, Joe.
Doris Day and the Deadwood Stage from the 1953 musical film Calamity Jane. Act 2 of Elaine Page on Sunday, well, it's going to begin straight after this intermission. And just to tell you, there's a big weepy coming up, so brace yourself, hankies at the ready. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 2 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. Thousands of people attempting to travel to France are facing a third day of delays despite the backlog easing at the port of Dover. There are still long queues for lorry drivers and holiday makers at the Eurotunnel terminal in Folkestone. Many drivers had to spend the night in their cars waiting to board trains. Georgina Keane was stuck in a queue for 16 hours yesterday. She said finding out what was going on was impossible.
There must have been, I don't know how many thousands of others, like myself, all having spent 15 to 16 hours trying to move 5 miles because there was nowhere, that Eurotunnel had nowhere to put us, so they left us on those roads to our own devices.
Russia has defended attacking the Ukrainian port of Odessa yesterday, claiming it hit a weapons stockpile and a warship. There's been international condemnation of the missile strike, which came just a day after Moscow signed an agreement to allow grain exports to resume from there. Both candidates to replace Boris Johnson as Prime Minister have pledged to crack down further on immigration. The Foreign Secretary Liz Truss has promised to expand the border force, while the former Chancellor Rishi Sunak says he'd narrow the definition of who qualifies for asylum. Critics say the UK would need to leave the European Convention on Human Rights if it did so. But the Welsh Secretary Sir Robert Buckland, who backs Mr Sunak, denies that.
You work, I think, to reform that at international level and also domestic. You focus upon what the definition of a refugee is under the 1951 Refugees Convention. And I think in some of the case law that we've seen from Strasbourg, the way in which that has been interpreted has been much more wide, I think, than perhaps was originally intended.
Pope Francis is on his way to Canada for a visit he's described as a pilgrimage of penance. He'll repeat a formal apology to Indigenous survivors of abuse inflicted at Roman Catholic schools. Unmarked graves were discovered last year at some sites. China's launched the second of 3 modules needed to complete its first space station. It's the latest stage of Beijing's ambitious space program. Michael Bristow reports.
The uncrewed craft successfully took off.